Dear students and my teacher friends, Namaskar. I welcome you to the presentation lecture on human endocrine system. Now, this lecture is the introductory lecture on human endocrine system. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss about exocrine gland, endocrine gland. What is the difference between the exocrine and the endocrine gland? Then we are going to see the exact location of various endocrine gland in our body and which are the hormone that they are secreting, and how all this exocrine, endocrine gland and their hormone, they constitute the human endocrine system that we are going to learn in this lecture. So starting with the first point, distinguish between exocrine and endocrine gland. What is the difference between exocrine and endocrine gland? See, in our body there are two type of glands are present. Two kind of glands are there. One type of glands are known as exocrine gland, and the second type of glands are the endocrine glands. Okay, so exocrine gland and endocrine gland. Now, exocrine gland, exo means outside. Okay, so what is the meaning of outside? See, this exocrine gland, they secrete their secretion, means their product. Exocrine gland secrete their product into the duct. Okay, so the secretion from exocrine gland are poured into the duct, and this secretion, they are carried by the duct, and they travel into the duct. Then this secretion, with the help of this duct, reaches to various body cavities. Then some secretion will reach into the lumen of an organ, or some secretion they come out or they reach to the surface of the body. So now, which are the exocrine gland that are present in our body? So sudoriferous gland or the sweat gland, which produces the sweat. Okay, then sebaceous gland, they secrete sebum, means oil. Then mucus gland, they produce mucus. And there are various digestive glands. These all are considered as the exocrine gland. So exocrine gland, in short, we are remembering this, that the exocrine gland, they pour their secretion into the duct, and via the duct this secretion travel into the body, and then this secretion reach to body cavities, lumen of organ or surface of the body. And sudoriferous, sebaceous, mucus and digestive gland are the example of exocrine gland. This is the first point of our discussion. Now moving on the second point of our discussion, in that we are discussing about the endocrine gland. See, endocrine, endo means within, means inside. Now this endocrine gland, they secrete their product, and their products are known as hormones. So endocrine gland secretes hormone, and this hormones, first they enter into the interstitial fluid. So the cells of endocrine gland, they are secretory cell. In our body there are various endocrine gland, different endocrine glands are there, and all this gland they are having different secretory cell, and this different secretory cell of different endocrine gland, they produce different type of hormone. And where these hormones are going, so this hormone, they first enter into the interstitial fluid, which is present around secretory cell. So this secretion or the hormone or the product is not entering into the duct. In case of exocrine gland, the secretion were entering into the duct, but here in endocrine gland, first the secretion or the hormone, they are entering into the interstitial fluid, and then from the interstitial fluid, this hormone, they diffuse into blood capillary. Okay, and we know in blood capillary, blood is there. That means now this hormone, they enter into the blood and they travel, they carried out by the blood. Okay, so from the blood, they reach to the target cell throughout the body. So so we know that, let's say one particular endocrine gland, and the cell of this endocrine gland, they secrete the hormone. Okay, so hormone first enters over here. You can see in this figure, endocrine gland, then cell of the endocrine gland, they are the secreting cell. So here endocrine cell is shown, and here interstitial fluid is there. So from this cell, hormone enters into this interstitial fluid, and from this hormone enters into the capillary. Okay, so here that's why they are showing the triangular shape they have used for hormone, and this is the blood capillary is shown, and in the capillary there is a blood. So now the hormones are carried by the blood, they are transporting with the blood. Okay, now we know this blood capillary, they join together, they form venule joint, they form vein open into vena cava, two vena cava, superior vena cava or inferior vena cava, superior or inferior vena cava, pouring the blood into the right atrium, then blood enters into right ventricle, then pulmonary tongue bifurcate into two artery, pulmonary artery supplying blood to two lung, left and right artery, arteriole, pulmonary capillary, venule, vein. So there are total four pulmonary vein, pouring oxygenated blood into left atrium, then left ventricle, aorta. From aorta there arises the artery, then from arteries there are arterioles, and from arteriole there arise the capillaries. Okay, so this is how the hormones, they are carried by the blood, and this is how these hormones are transported to various parts of the body, and they are reaching to their target cell. So at the tissue level, from the systemic capillary, this hormone diffuse out and they will enter into the target cell. They will come in contact with the target cell and they will bring changes into the target cell. So in the target cell, various cellular process will start or stop. Okay, so so now this hormone, okay, as they are dependent on the cardiovascular system, circulatory system, to distribute their product, means this endocrine system or the endocrine gland, they are secreting their product hormones, and this hormones, to travel this hormone, they are dependent on the cardiovascular or the circular system. So That's why these endocrine glands, they are considered as the most vascular tissue of the body. And see, in our body, for various activity, the hormones, they are required in very small amount. And that's why a very low level of hormone are circulated with the blood. So in the blood, there is very less amount or very low amount of hormones are, or small amount of hormones are present in the blood. Okay, so this is the second point of our discussion. Now the third point. Now the example of endocrine gland. So pituitary gland is endocrine gland, thyroid gland, endocrine gland, parathyroid is endocrine gland, adrenal is endocrine gland, pineal is endocrine gland. So these are the example of endocrine gland. So here in the figure I am showing you, for example, you see the pituitary gland is shown. You follow the black color arrow, they are using, and they are showing this pituitary gland. And here you try to remember all the names. So the hormones of pituitary gland, for example, anterior pituitary releases or secrete ACTH, TH, GH, PRL, FSH, LH, MSH. So try to remember all the names of the hormones. Then here, pineal gland secretes melatonin. Thyroid gland produces thyroxine, triiodothyronine, calcitonin. Then here adrenal gland is shown. Okay, adrenal gland, medulla, cortex. So adrenal medulla hormone, adrenal cortex hormone. Okay, now besides the endocrine gland, in our body several organ and tissues are also producing some hormone. Okay, they are also secreting hormone. So which are these organs that they producing hormones? So hypothalamus is such kind of organ. Okay, then thymus, pancreas, ovaries, testes, kidneys, stomach, liver, small intestine, skin, heart, adipose tissue, and placenta. All these organs, they are also secreting various kind of hormones. So hormones, see, hypothalamus hormone, then you see the location and try to remember the hormones which are produced by hypothalamus. Then thymus, heart, which hormone produced by heart. Then digestive tract hormone, pancreatic islet, insulin, glucagon, somatostatin. Okay, then kidney, erythropoietin, calcitriol, renin. Okay, then testes produces testosterone, inhibin. Then ovaries, estrogen, progesterone, inhibin, relaxin. Okay, so this is the third point. Now moving on the fourth point of our discussion, And this information, you go through this information, okay. Then this figure, you can read this functions of hormones, okay. Then location of many endocrine glands. So you see exactly which endocrine gland, where it is located in our body, okay. What is the name of endocrine gland and where it is located. Then here in this figure, here you see skin produces which hormone, for example calciferol, okay. Then trigger effect, then heart produces adrenal, natrio uretic hormone, then trigger effect of this hormone, then stomach, duodenum, colon. Then adipose tissue, okay, adipose tissue, leptin hormone, okay. Then here duodenum, so duodenum produces which hormone, stomach secretes which hormone, kidney produces which hormone, okay. Okay, so all this endocrine gland together with the body organ and the tissues which are secreting the hormone, they constitute the endocrine system. Okay, endocrine glands plus organs plus tissues which are secreting hormone, they are forming endocrine system. Endo means within, crino to secrete. Then the science of structure and function of endocrine gland means which type of cells are present in particular endocrine gland and what are the function of endocrine gland means which type of hormones are secreted, what are the structure of hormones and where these hormones are affecting, where they are acting, which are the target cell of this particular hormone. So all this and diagnosis and treatment of disorder of the endocrine system. See, hormones, as we now know that they are required in very small amount. So if the level of particular hormone is increases or the level of particular hormone is decreases, so person suffers from disorders which are related with the abnormal level of the hormones. Okay, so the science, the branch of science which study the structure and function of endocrine gland, and the branch of science which is diagnosing and treating the disorder of the endocrine system, that branch of science is known as endocrinology means logy. Logy means study of, and logy means study. So with this we have completed this introductory presentation lecture on human endocrine system. I hope you have enjoyed this presentation lecture, and I also hope that this presentation lecture will be helpful in your exam preparation and also in your studies. My name is Manish Koshti, sir. I am from Ahmedabad, India. Bye-bye. Namaste.